Hey guys, in this video is all about is how to do the Xref to the AutoCAD drawing. This is I use the version is AutoCAD 2016, and I'm going to use this drawing after Xref for the drawing 1 and drawing 2. Now let's start with the drawing 1. To do the Xref, you have to type Xref and it will show the here Xref, and then this table is coming, and the next you have to press this button. It says attach DWG. And then you have to go to the your Xref file location, and here is my location on the desktop. You can double click on it or just press on it and click the open, and then this is the reference for the option where you want to put. And I want it just specific on screen, yeah. And then just click OK. And you have to specify anywhere you want. Now is the Xref is coming to the drawing number 1, and then I am going to do the same thing in the drawing number 2. Now this time I show you the necessary or the important of the Xref, why we need to do the Xref. For example, this I have 100 drawing. It is that the example is only 2, but if for example the I have 100 drawing that need to have the same Xref. And now I do something on the drawing 2, and drawing 1 I draw the rectangle and then cell, and drawing number 2 cell. Now let's start with the Xref. For example, I change the word Hanuman to subscribe. Okay. And then let's see the drawing number 1 is still display Hanuman, and the drawing number 2 is still display. And now I save the graph file. And then you come here to the drawing number 1. Here it display the error. Drawing number 2 is also. Now let's see. It said it need to reloading. To reload the Xref, you have to right click on it, and then you have to click on reload. And then it's become subscribe. And for the drawing number 2, if you cannot find this table, it's easy, you just close it and then open the drawing again, and the Xref file is automatically reload. And as I said in the beginning, the Xref file is help you a lot if you have the same layout for many drawing that you don't have to update all the drawing one by one. So you just close all the drawing and then open it again, and the Xref file is reload. OK, Okay, now I change the word to thank you for your time. One more thing, if you want to delete your Xref file, you have to right click on, first I close it, you have to type Xref for the Xref table is coming, and then right click on the Xref file and detach it, and the Xref file is disappear from your layout. One more, if you, second way is if you click on the Xref and delete it, the Xref file still in your drawing, you cannot. That means the Xref file is disappear, it's deleted already, but it still have the link to your drawing. So the drawing have maybe it's heavier than the normal one. So I recommend to do the first step is better than the second step. It's the detach and the it's clear the Xref from your drawing, and then save it. And for the one more thing is the important thing. For example, you have to I change this it's about the unit. This drawing is used the unit is the inch, so I change it to millimeter, and this one unit is still remain inch. So I save it, and then drawing number two I save it again. Now let's try to attach the Xref again. As you can see, the drawing is become bigger, much bigger than the previous one, and I try to measuring the dimension. The dimension is not the same because this the layout is draw in the inch, and the this drawing is used the millimeter. So please make sure before you do the Xref, you have to set the unit to the same thing. So now I try to set the unit to inch, follow the Xref file, okay, and then I save it. Reload. We cannot detach and again. Now it's become smaller, and then try to measuring dimension again, it's the same. So it's it is very important with this command UNITS unit. You must check this the insertion scale. This house in feet, mile, millimeter, and another thing you can read. Make sure the Xref and the layout is the same. If not the same, you will face the problem in the future for all the drawing. Okay, thank you again for your time watching this video. I hope this video helped you to do your Xref by your own without any mistake. Please drop your comment. If you need some help from me, I will try my best to reply all the comments. in below, and don't forget to subscribe for more video, and bye bye, have a nice day.